am so excited with this topic. Let's quickly go to, let's study what's the gift of tongues. Have you heard the people speaking in tongues? Hila baka sudrikala shaba khatur khata pahsi didirika bahi saba kudi dirabahadi laka shubarakadi. Now, have you heard anything like this? Hello, and let me tell you, today is a day of blessing. Okay, 1 Corinthians 14 verse 2 says, For he that speaks in a tongue, in an unknown tongue, speaks not to man, but to God. For no man understands him, howbeit in the spirit he speaks mysteries. Now, according to this scripture, I just began to speak in tongues. And the Bible says, the one who speaks in tongues does not speak to man. Now, did I speak to you? Hello? According to this word, did I speak to you? Please go to that scripture. He says, a person who speaks in an unknown tongue speaks not to man, but to God. So, do we now have an STD connection? Hello? ISD connection to heaven, right to the heart of God. You can talk to God directly. So when I was speaking in tongues, did I speak to you? No. So when you speak in tongues, you are speaking to God directly. And the good news is, you don't understand what you speak. Wow. Because you are speaking the mysteries of God. What is the meaning of the word mystery? The word mystery means something that is secret, something that is hidden, something that is unknown. So when I'm speaking in tongues, the best part is I myself do not know what I'm speaking. Hallelujah. So this time I'm stuck in one place. Praise God. Okay, let's come back. When a person is speaking in tongues, what happens? He's speaking what? The mystery of God. He's speaking to whom? To God. Now, do you believe this scripture? So if you believe this scripture, will you not long to get this gift? Come on. Lord, if you can give me this gift, then I can talk to you anytime directly and nobody can interfere. Even the devil can't interfere. Praise God. Hallelujah. And what am I speaking? I'm speaking mysteries of God. Now, watch this. From 2 days, you have been listening to God's word, right? When I'm preaching. Are you getting more and more desire to listen to God's word? Are you just sitting there and saying, when this person is speaking, it is as if he's talking to me? Do you feel like that? Yes. And you're saying, I got this problem and I want to go for counseling and I'm going to ask him. And that's the time I'm speaking a word which is answering your question. And you're saying, oh my God, he just gave me the answer. Do you want to know what is the secret? Oh, you don't want to know. Forget it. You know, what is he saying? When a person is speaking in tongues, he's speaking what? Mysteries. He's speaking what? Secrets. Mysteries of God. Okay, now, before I can come here to preach the word of God, I already finished preaching the sermon that I'm supposed to preach here in tongues. I was not there. I'd gone to the chapel and there I was speaking the whole teaching from now till we go for supper. The whole sermon has been already preached in tongues. And when I spoke it out of my mouth, I spoke it in a mystery. I did not understand. Now watch this, what he says in verse number 13. Wherefore is therefore, okay? Therefore, let him that speaks in an unknown tongue pray that he may he may interpret or translate. Translate is when you take a language and you speak in another language word to word. But interpretation is a person spoke for 15 or 20 minutes and you speak the summary. You get the summary out of it. Is interpretation. I can speak for 15, 20 minutes and you can speak that, what I spoke, that message in just two lines. So when I do not know what to come and preach, I tell the Lord, Lord, what I spoke in tongues, please reveal it back to me in human wisdom. That's called interpretation. And that is why when I'm preaching, I suddenly stop and I say, thank you, Lord. Have you heard that? Hello? Did you hear that? Okay. As I'm preaching, suddenly say, stop. Let's have the healing session. And I suddenly stop and I say, okay, who's got this problem? Let's come out. Why? Because he is taking over the whole class, not me. When he says, you do this, I do the same. How do I get this power? I get this power by the gift of tongues. And then when I ask for interpretation, he comes and gives me the interpretation. And now when I'm speaking exactly to the situation that you're going through. Isn't that a powerful gift? Oh, you did not like it. Hallelujah. So when you get this gift is called the master key. It's called the, because on the day of Pentecost, the disciples and the apostles got one gift. And what was that gift? The gift of tongues. And when they got this gift, they relied on this gift. And this gift opened up all the other gifts and the charism. If you see Peter, when he received the gift of tongues, he got out of the room when he was feeling scared. He came out with boldness and he spoke the word. And when he spoke the word, people's hearts were touched and they got converted. And they said, okay, what will we do now? Now that we have crucified the Son of God, is there any way that can save us? And that's the time Peter says, believe in the Lord Jesus and be baptized. You will be saved, and even those who will come after you will be saved, and you will receive the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Praise God. Now, when I was speaking on confession, did it touch your heart? Hello? Why did it touch your heart? Because I was also speaking under the anointing of the Holy Spirit. If I'm speaking the same sermon and the anointing is not there, the whole preaching will be dry. You will not be convicted. I'm not saying you will be condemned, but you will be convicted. And that's why you will find this time when you went for confession, it was different. Have you realized that? Come on, you began to pour out your heart and you said, I do not want any of those coins. I want to throw them and never pick them up. Amen. Amen. Praise God. So, is it that you are hungry for this gift? Hello? Are you getting hungry for this gift? Okay, here we go. Please read. The ability to speak in tongues comes from Holy Spirit. Because on the day of Pentecost, in Acts 2, let's go to Acts 2 and see what does it say. When the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with See, listen, if you are in a group of people and you are praying and supposing you are not in one accord, be 100% sure the Holy Spirit will not manifest. Holy Spirit manifests where there the atmosphere is an atmosphere of love. You got to be in one accord. You got to be in unity. And praise God, this evening we are all in one. We are all in one. We are all in one. And suddenly, say that word suddenly. Say that again. Say that again. Say that again. Please remember, you will agree with me, accidents happen. Tragedies happen. wrong things happen. In the same way, the working of the Holy Spirit is also. Many a times you pray to God and you say, yes, Lord, I've made a prayer and now I'll get the answer after 1 month. Now it happens. You got up in the morning and you did not even know C5 is going to be fixed today. Praise God. And you were listening to the word of God and suddenly the Lord said, come on, get up, sister, and come and let's fix the bone. It happened. Shake your neighbor and tell your neighbor, the power of God works in you. Miracles happen in you. Healing comes to you. Blessings come to you. Protection comes on you. Angels of God are bringing great things in your life. Prosperity is working in your life. Praise God. Suddenly, you know, when you believe, you scream. When you don't believe and you are doubting, oh, is it true? Praise God. Suddenly. And today also we will see, suddenly. Listen, the anointing of the Holy Spirit will depend on your believing. It's not depending on your begging. You can be begging, give me. For 10 years, it's not coming. But you believe? Instantly it will be done. Is there anybody over here who had been praying for the gift of tongues for many years? Come on. Nobody. Okay. Do you all have the gift of tongues? Then I better change the topic. How many of you got the gift of tongues? Uh-huh. How many of you don't have the gift of tongues? Uh-huh. If you are keeping it this way, I am guaranteeing you, you will get only 50%. Because God looks at your 25%, 50%, 75%, 100%. How many of you do not have the gift of tongues? And how many of you desire for this gift? Good, lot many. Praise God. And all those who have lifted your hands up, had you ever heard that there is such a gift? Yes. Didn't you ever long for it? Yes. How many of you longed for more than 1 year? Don't tell a lie. Come on. For more than 1 year? How many years? Wow. Listen. Wow. You will be the first one to speak in tongues. I'll tell you, sister. The Spirit of God will give you the power to speak in tongues. And listen. I'm going to call her here. When she understands the whole teaching, then she will say, my God, it was so easy. And I've been struggling from 1995, 2005, 2011, been 16 years. Praise God. Hallelujah. So suddenly there came a sound. Say that sound. Say that again, sound. From heaven as of a rushing mighty wind. So many people feel that there was a mighty wind. Uh-huh. On the day of Pentecost there was no wind. There was a sound. The wind is blowing again. There was no wind. I said there was no wind. It was just a sound of the wind. Hallelujah. And it filled. And it filled. And it filled. So tonight, what is going to happen? Fill. 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 That's what you got to learn. See, when you read the Bible, don't read it as a storybook. If you read it all, you must say all. Lord, all. And the devil will say, listen, you are not going to get. You tell the devil, shut up. It's given all. That if it is given all, it is. If it is given all, it is.
All.
Say that again.
All.
Say that again.
All.
Look at your neighbor and say it to your neighbor.
All.
Say that again.
All.
You know why I tell you to. Do you know why I tell you to talk to your neighbor all? Why to speak the word? Faith comes by. Faith comes by. Faith comes by. So if your neighbor is dreaming, you shake your neighbor and talk to your neighbor, then faith will. Amen. Hallelujah. There are many a times people can sit and be like this. but they are looking at me, but they are in the kitchen. Because many a time when you go on a Sunday morning for Mass, the priest is giving a sermon and the person will be, and the priest will be saying, wow, look at her, so attentive. And what is she thinking, looking at the priest? Cock, 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 cock. Amen. Oh. After the Mass, what should I go and buy? Should I buy chicken? Mutton? Oh. And some of them. Praise the Lord. So it filled all the house where they were. Where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cleven tongues like as of fire, and it sat upon some of them. Some of them. Shake your neighbor and tell your neighbor, can you see that? Each of them. Listen, you should study the Bible this way. And when you study the Bible this way, and the devil comes and says, you are not qualified. Who told you, devil? The Bible says each of them. If it is each of them on that day, each of them today, because the word of God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Give the Lord a big hand. Come on. Hallelujah. 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 Now, are you qualified?
Yes.
Will you even doubt?
No.
Because if the word of God says each of them, it is each of them. And today we learn the power is in us. All we got to do is open the tap. Now, why am I taking such time? I'm taking the time so that you open the tap of your mind and agree with the word of God, and you will find the power flowing. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Okay. Speaking in tongues is one of the identifying signs of the new creation. Is there anybody who believes in Jesus here? Lord, you can see their hands. You know, when I said, is there anybody who believes in Jesus? You lifted your hand. Now let me tell you, your action corresponds to the message. The moment you lifted your hand, heaven is watching you. It is not a game. It is your faith that is seen. For example, Jesus saw the faith of that man being lowered from the roof, and he said, come on, rise up and walk. Jesus saw their faith and healed the crippled man. So now the same Lord is seeing your faith when you lift your hand. Praise God. Now look, watch this. And Jesus said to them, go you into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believes and is baptized shall be
saved.
Shall be
saved.
Shall be
saved.
Is there anybody who is baptized in the name of Jesus? No, there might be somebody. Listen, baby. Might be you are not baptized. Okay? I'm going to call you too, along with that sister. You will be speaking in tongues. Even if you are not baptized, I got another promise that can get you baptized with the Holy Ghost. Don't you worry. Because when you read that, you said, oh God, I just got disqualified. But let me tell you, my Jesus sees that everyone can get qualified. Amen.
Amen.
Hey soldier, amen.
Amen.
So don't get depressed. You know, when I asked you, is there anybody who is not baptized? And you said everyone is baptized. Listen, might be there with somebody who is not baptized. And when the person hears that, hey, I'm not baptized, that means I just got disqualified. I came for the retreat. I came to the finishing line and I got disqualified. No, you did not. There is something in the Bible even for you. Okay. All those who are baptized, watch this. But he that believeth not shall be damned. These signs shall follow them that
believe.
Did he say these signs shall follow them that believe and are baptized? Did he say that? What did he say? Now, how many of you believe in Jesus? All of you. So watch that. He said, "These signs shall follow. So when you are walking, who is supposed to follow? So do you have to sweat? Sign come, no, come. Signs and wonders, miracles come, healing come, wonders of God come. Do you have to call them? No, they are supposed to follow you. Are you getting it? How many times you are sweating, Lord, I'm going, please do something, Lord, please do something. You don't have to do that. When you're walking, they are just following you. Come. He said, they will. So if I run this side, signs are running where? So if you understand this scripture, will you be sweating to get signs and wonders working in your life? Not at all. Can you change your thinking? Tell your neighbor, wherever I go,
signs and wonders
follow me,
because
I believe in Jesus. Aha. Is the chest coming out? Shoulders growing? Come on. Aren't you getting strengthened? Yeah. Now, did he say, wherever you go, the demons will follow you? No. Signs will follow you. And what are the signs? In my name, they shall. Tell your neighbor, in the name of Jesus,
it is my birthright,
my inheritance
to cast out
demons. Do you have some? I can get it out. Husband and wife were talking, and the wife is saying, do you have some? The husband is saying, do you have some? Praise God. Hallelujah. So from now on, according to this word, who is supposed to fear? You or the demons? So every day, what will you confess? In the name of Jesus, it is my birthright to cast out demons. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. They shall speak in new tongues. Who? Those who believe in Jesus. So, according to this word, is it your birthright?
Yes.
Come on, tell your neighbor, it is my birthright.
It is my inheritance.
To speak in new tongues.
Sister,
you were praying for 95. Did you ever know that it was your birthright? No. You were all the time waiting. Jesus, give me now. And now Jesus is saying, it is your birthright. Okay, here we go. They shall take up serpents, and if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. Now, please, for heaven's sake, don't go and try this. You will say, Lord, you said I can pick up serpents, and in the ground there might be some holes where you are staying right now. And you will say, hey, snake, hello. I have come to catch you. Hallelujah. Don't do that. You know what it means? St. Paul, when he put wood in the fire, there was a viper, and the viper bit him. What did St. Paul do? He took the snake and put it in the fire and began to praise God. And the people who saw him said, he's going to be dead. But he was praising God, and the snake bite had no effect, and the snake bite brought conversion in the whole village. And if they drink any deadly thing, so let's say somebody has done with lime and with chilies and all those things. Now, even if they do all those things, it will have no effect on you when you believe in Jesus. Now tell me, are you going to be scared of lime and chilies? You know, we Christians, if we open the door the next morning and there is a chili with a lime outside your door, Oh my God. Hello? Is it right? And if you have that kind of a fear, it will surely destroy you. But when you have this scripture that says it will have no effect on you, you can open your mouth, kick that lime and the chili and say, in the name of Jesus, you demon, you are under my feet. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. Satan is under my feet. Dun, 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 dun. Hallelujah. I remember one of the brother, he was the president in the field of occult and witchcraft, and he was a Christian. And when his brother brought him for the retreat, he said, brother, I ignorantly landed up there and now I'm a president. I do not want to stay there. I want to come out. But the person who is doing all this, he can fix me up in 1 minute. He can take a doll, put a needle on it, and if he puts a needle on the leg, my leg will not move. I've seen it. And I said, that's it? Okay, what you got that he has given you? So he showed me something. And I said, let's see. If you can give me that, I'll show you what I can do. I took it and I stamped it under my feet. And I said, ha ha ha, Satan, you are under my feet. Now he looked at it and began to wonder, what am I doing? I said, do you know, the ones who believe in Jesus, these things have no power over us. We have power over them. Now if your man is thinking he's powerful, I just stamped it. Let him do something against me. Let's check it out. Go and tell him. Because I believe in Jesus. Nothing will happen to me, neither my family. So he looked at it and said, can I come out of this? I can, surely you can come out. If you call on Jesus, if you repent, if you confess, the next moment you will be free. And he repented, confessed, changed his life, and today he is a complete Christian and he is organizing retreats for us in Coimbatore. And when he came out, he brought so many of those people out of that person's clutches. If witchcraft and occult is powerful, praise God, when you believe in Jesus, all those powers are under your feet. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Then they shall lay hands on the sick and they shall surely die. So when you lay hands on the sick, they will surely die. Tell your neighbor, when I lay hands on the sick, they shall surely recover. My hands are anointed. In the name of Jesus. Should I touch you? You shall be healed. Amen. I pray this way. My prayers are funny. Like when I spoke about the stone, I said, hey stone, what are you looking here and there? Look at me, man. I'm talking to you. What are you looking here and there? It looks a funny prayer. But that's how I pray. I'm talking to that thing. And when I talk to that thing and I say, get out, it has to go out because I have the power of attorney in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Hello, amen.
Amen.
So are your hands anointed?
Yes.
Do you believe it?
Yes.
You will see the glory. Okay, let's have a test. Anybody having any pain? Come on. Let there be one at least, Lord. One at least. That's why. Oh, there's one. Good. Hey, baby. Hey, baby in red. Come here. Do you believe in Jesus? Do you believe in Jesus? No, no, I'm asking her. A small baby. If the small baby can fix that pain, what about the big babies? You understand English? Yes. Hold a hand. What pain you got? Back pain. Okay. Back pain, leg pain, body pain. Hold a hand. And baby, you are going to repeat the prayer that I will tell you. Okay, close your eyes. Close your eyes. Say this, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
I just now heard.
I just now, Lord.
Your word saying.
Your word saying.
All those who believe in you.
All those who believe in you.
These signs will follow them.
these signs and follow them.
Lord Jesus, I believe in you. I believe your word. Your word says. When I lay hands on the sick. Just hold her. She's going to fall. Hold her. She's going to fall. Close your eyes. Say this. Lord Jesus.
I thank you for teaching this truth.
Lord Jesus.
You said.
When I lay hands on the sick. They shall be healed. Lord Jesus. Believing in your word.
I lay my hand.
On the precious sister. Your power is flowing into her.
The power is falling into her.
And destroying.
Every pain.
Every pain.
In a body.
And she has recovered. According to your word.
Thank you, Jesus.
I proclaim.
Before heaven and earth.
I am anointed. My hands are anointed.
My dear sister.
Jesus loves you.
Jesus has healed you.
My pain is gone. Your pain is gone. And you are healed.
Amen.
She's still drunk. The power is all over her. She's sweating. This is not a joke. The baby began to believe, and for the first time she's praying, and the other person gets knocked off. You know, she's drunk. Just hold on. Okay, open your eyes. Turn your back. Look at that smile. The baby could get the healing for you. Give me a hard one, man. Hard one. Yeah. You know, I would love to have children in my team than having elders in my team. Because elders are reasoning. How can I pray? Look at the children. Hey, pain, get out. Do you believe? So, in Christian living, is there any boasting? Hey, I prayed over you and you got healed. So what? Even the baby can do that. Because the baby did not know the power was in her. The promise opened the tap, the power began to flow. And if I had not to shout, she would have been on the floor. She was stopping the Holy Ghost from doing, because she was trying to hold herself. I don't want to fall. Is it right? If you let go of yourself and say, Holy Spirit, take me. I want to be drunk in your love. Wow. I got knocked off the first time for 8 hours. And it was so beautiful. I did not even want to come back. Now, do you believe?
Yes.
Tell your neighbor, my hands are anointed. Should I touch you? Hallelujah. Is there any boasting now? I prayed, I did this, and I did this. It's the word in you that did it. Give the Lord a big hand. You know, the way you are clapping tells me how much you enjoyed this revelation. And you're saying, my God, it's so easy. God does everything easy. Sister, the Lord is talking to you. That's what he said. When I am preaching the word of God, suddenly the power of God will come on you. And that suddenly tongues of fire is on you. Close your eyes. That's exactly what is happening. Don't touch her. as you believe, the Holy Spirit just comes and touches you. The Bible says when Peter was still preaching, the Holy Spirit fell on them and tongues of fire came upon them. This is the day of Pentecost. When he was preaching in Cornelius' house, a pagan who did not even know Jesus, the Bible says the Holy Ghost came upon them suddenly. Peter could not even stop his preaching. He was still preaching and the Holy Ghost began to move. Instead of you looking here and there, you know what you should say? Lord, I'm longing for the same. Lord, I'm longing for the same. Lord, I'm thirsting for the same. Lord, I'm believing that you are in me. I am renewing my mind to receive you. Even as I'm speaking, the love of God is flowing in this place. His anointing is flowing in this place. If you use your reasoning, you'll be watching everybody but getting nothing. But if you can only close your eyes and talk to the Lord and say, Lord, even I want to experience that, you will experience His power. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. That's exactly what happened during the time of Peter. It's happening now. Did I say it happens suddenly? Did I say it will happen suddenly?
Yes.
Is it happening suddenly?
Yes.
Oh yeah. It will always happen suddenly. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So then, after the Lord had spoken unto them, this girl in red dupatta, can you just stand? The Lord is going to touch you now. I'm talking to you. Do you want that power? Stand up. Close your eyes. And say, Lord Jesus, I give my heart to you. And I thank you for touching me. I thank you for touching me. I thank you for touching me. Just keep ready. She's going to fall now. Just be ready. Don't touch her. She's just getting drunk in the spirit. That's the power of God all over you, sister. There he goes. Hold her. Stanley. You know, he heard your whisper. You said, Lord, I can see her being touched. Please touch me too. These were the words that you said. These were the words you said. And the Holy Spirit is touching you. Look here, baby. Did you say those words? Yeah. Yeah. I was about to take the next line and he said, wait. She just said these words. You just whispered. And he spoke to me and said, this is what she's saying. I want to touch her. He loves you. Could you ever believe that a whisper from your heart, your neighbor did not hear it. He heard it. You said, Lord, what she got? Even I want that. Did you say that? In inverted commas, same words. Sit down and talk to him. Listen, if you're going to wait for him to come, he's not coming. He's in you. You got to learn to talk. You got to learn to have that fellowship. And life becomes so beautiful. You will never be living a natural life. You'll be living a supernatural life. Look at this lady. She's drunk in the spirit. She's slain. She's not even in this world. She's enjoying the love of God. Beautiful love of God. That's what he says. So then, after the Lord had spoken to them, he was received up into heaven and sat on the right hand of God, and they went forth preaching everywhere. The Lord, what? The Lord, who is this Lord? Hello, who is this Lord? Jesus is taken up into heaven, and Jesus has sent another person. His name is Holy Spirit. And remember, when you are a disciple of Christ, the Holy Spirit is always working with you. Who are the disciples? Hello, are you a disciple? How do you say that? How do you know you are a disciple? Jesus said, my disciples are the ones who will walk in love. They shall know that you are my disciples by your love and not by your preaching. Not by your any of your service, but by your love. Unconditional, dying to self service. He said, if you are my disciple, you will pick up your cross and follow me. And if you are a person who is having that kind of an attitude, then the Lord will always be working with you. And when you open your mouth and you speak, the Lord will confirm every word that is being preached with accompanying signs. That is what the Bible says in Romans 8. His Spirit will bear witness with our spirit that we are sons and daughters of God. When you speak and there is no manifestation, something is wrong with you. There has to be a manifestation. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So, when a person is speaking in tongues, it is an identifying sign that he is a new creation. Speaking in tongues is an evidence of receiving the Holy Spirit. Now, listen. There are two times that the Holy Spirit shows up. One, when a person gets born again. That is the day when the Holy Spirit comes into you. That's exactly what happened when Jesus rose from the dead. He came and met his disciples and he said in the Gospel of John, receive the Holy Spirit, and he breathed the Holy Spirit into them and they got born again. They got born again, but the Holy Spirit had not yet come upon them. The Holy Spirit had come to dwell in them. There are two baptisms. One is when the Holy Spirit comes into you and makes your spirit new creation. That's what we learned. But there is one more time when the Holy Spirit comes upon you with fire. And that's the time it is an empowerment that you receive by which you can cast out demons, heal the sick, preach the gospel. There are different gifts, there are different charisms, and your whole life begins to change. So everybody who are seated here have got the baptism of the Holy Spirit in them. But not everybody has got the baptism of the fire. Because the day the baptism of fire comes, there will be signs, there will be wonders. Amen? Praise the Lord. Let us close our eyes. Loving Father, thank you and praise you. We give you praise, we give you glory. Thank you, Lord, that your word brings so much of understanding and revelation. And thank you for manifesting your glory. We give you praise. We give you glory. In Jesus' name, amen.